But like that's just something like that's sort of been like memed out of me. Like that's been assigned to me, and you can either be a dick about it, or you can either embrace it. And like because I had all this train knowledge, I remember at Mr. X, we were working on Enola Holmes, and we did the big train fight sequence on Enola Holmes. And I wasn't on that show yet, but I was on I was on another show. I was on The Alienist. And being around other people, and they were doing this train scene, and the supervisor, I remember looking, and she was saying, "Oh, and you have to move the logs, move these logs, and get the stones." And I'm like, "Move the logs and get the stones? Like, what are you talking about?" And I looked over, and I was like, "Oh, the sleepers and the ballast." It's the proper term, the sleep. And she was like, "Oh, how did you know?" And I'm like, "Well, let me have a look." And I'm like, what are you doing? The ballast would never fall. That would be terrible for drainage. Is that even a 4.5 foot gauge? That'll te You would never have fish plates that close together. Are you kidding me? What
Did
are
you
you
screw
doing?
that clockwise or counterclockwise?
Yeah, exactly. And they were like, how do you know so much about trains? And I'm just like, don't ask. And then like, so I went on all the homes. I did a bit of the a bit of the trains on that.
Word got out.
Yeah, and that's when Snowpiercer was next. And they were like,
Yes.
oh, David's a train guy, he can help on Snowpiercer. And I was just like, fuck. It's okay. I was like, I don't want to be known as the train guy, but you know, whatever. Like, Snowpiercer is kind of cool. Like, I had to texture this entire train, and it was a massive, massive challenge. And it was like that show was really hard at the time because that was peak COVID in 2020, and all the companies were letting people go, and all the companies were taking on work that they didn't have people for because they were letting everybody go. So that was super stressful. But so yeah, so there was Snowpiercer. And then I was like, haha, it's funny. I've done two train things. And then my last show at Mr. X was The Harder They Fall, and I had to model the train. And I was like, of course I have to model the train. Of course that came in for me. And at this point I'm just like, you know, I'll just smash it out. So I smashed that out, and then my supervisor left to come to Deneg, and then I left X after I finished that show and came to Deneg. And my supervisor on The Harder They Fall also doing a train, and I was just like, ah, this is it. I just have to subscribe to this now. This is my stereotype that I am the train guy. And
Yeah, you got typecast just like actors and stuff do, right?
I work I all there was another show that's not out yet, untitled train show that I worked on at X. I'm sure I can't talk about.
Yeah, so we'll know, we'll find out eventually. Yeah,
Which, yeah,
we'll
we'll
see it
find
on
out
your
at the end of the
IMDb
year.
page. Everyone, Google him.
Oh
Yeah,
yeah.
yeah.
Thanks for listening to the CG Spectrum podcast. For more on this episode, visit us at cgspectrum.com/podcast. Check out our show notes, where you'll find links to our guests and more behind the scenes. And if you're enjoying the show, please like, rate, review, and subscribe wherever you're listening, or share this episode with someone who might like it. See you next time.